Odissi, and I'm an Odissi dancer, and I've also trained in CHOWK, Saraikela CHOWK, which is a traditional dance form from the east of India. So it's very close to Odissi. And so I develop my contemporary work draws from these two forms. So yes, we do classical work, I do contemporary work, I do everything, but the roots are classical, the roots are from Odissi. I still consider myself an Odissi dancer, and I always knew that I didn't want to be a classical performer. I wanted to do something else with the form, trying to use the vocabulary to create contemporary work, because this whole idea of that contemporary is Western is, I don't agree with it. Like, I feel, you know, we have such a strong vocabulary, we have so much to draw from, that we can create our own experimental work without looking at the West or drawing anything, or fusing forms, like fusing Indian and Western forms. So that's my path, you know, drawing from the classical and creating experimental work. So I started in 2000, many years ago, 19 years ago, okay. So that was the first time I tried using CHOWK, not Odissi, to do a production. So my first production was called Masks of God in 2000. It was in Delhi when I lived in India. It was only after doing that I realized that, you know, classical and traditional forms are so strong, and they are so tightly knit, you know, the music, the hand gestures, the stories, the, you know, the iconography, the whole history, it's so tightly knit that one cannot just isolate, you know, one element from that and call it contemporary. That's when I realized that can't be done. So I needed to develop it further. I needed to think about it more. And so that's how I started. So I did. In India, I did. Because in India, especially in Delhi, there is no scope for failure. There is no scope, there is no space where you can experiment and fail. Because if you do, then people will just tear you apart. Yeah. So we were, after that, it was me and another dancer, two of us tried this. We were totally, you know, we got bad reviews, and a lot of, we did get a lot of flack, and we were called like, yeah. So it was a very bad period. For every performance, firstly, I try to see that each production is totally different from what I've done before. So I never go back to a choreography. I don't even watch videos of my old work, so that, you know, so something I'm doing, and I have a very bad memory, so I forget. So so when I'm doing something new, I just work with that. And I always go back to the basics, like the basics that I was practicing, those are the basics of Odissi. Those are the basic 20 steps. I always go back to the basics, and I work on the floor, and I see what works and what haven't I used in the earlier production. So each production I try to something new, you know, I try to move away from what I've done. Costumes are always what is appropriate for the production, because now I feel we are not doing Odissi. Like, even the classical works that I did, that Pallavi with time, space, and what was the last one? Stillness. When I performed in India, I took out the costume. and we just did it in rehearsal clothes, because I feel I've moved away so much from the form that the costume is not needed. Because the moment you wear costume, there is a certain expectation that it's going to be classical and it's going to be a certain way. So I try to move away from that. It was an overwhelming response because I was going back to India after many years, so after more than a decade, and most of the people there had heard about what we were doing in Singapore, and you know, they were aware of what we were doing, but they hadn't seen a whole production. So when we did the production, it was very overwhelming. They were very amazed and they actually loved it. I think everything changes when you have, so in India there's no space to experiment and fail, but once you've got a product which works, then they are willing to accept it. But there is no space like substation in India. And also in Singapore, also what really had a very strong influence on me was ITI, you know, the theatre school. So there they teach No and Wang Wong and Beijing Opera. So I watched these forms very closely when I came here. You know, I saw how they trained and how they used those traditional forms to create their works. So that was very fascinating for me, and that also had a very strong influence on how I work. And yeah, and they are just next door, so it's a very strong influence on my work and the people I choose to work with. So I'm hoping that people learn Odissi like they should in Singapore. It shouldn't be, you know, they shouldn't look towards India. You know, we are learning Odissi here. We have to make that our own. Of course, the training has to be, there has to be rigor. But we shouldn't be looking towards India to get the big dancers in when we do productions. That they'll do the main dance and, you know, our dancers will be somewhere in the side. And we'll sell tickets because there are these big names coming from India. You know, it's high time Singapore stopped doing that with Indian dance. We have to make it our own. And our productions should have just Singaporean dancers. And it has to be belong to Singapore. So that's what I'm trying to do in CHOWK. And I hope that happens. Like, you know, we have to stop looking and behaving like, you know, we are lesser than them.
So like them to make it our own.
Yes, it's time to make it our own, and this is developed, like what we do at CHOWK, I feel has developed here. And we don't need to look towards India. We develop this and take it further. Yeah.
Okay.